Hello students, in the previous session I had worked out some problems in which I converted the sum or difference of two trigonometric functions into a product and vice versa, that is a product into either sum or difference. And two more problems I worked out where I had proved certain result. In today's session also I am going to prove certain result. So the instruction is prove the following. Now first problem is cos of A plus cos of 120 minus A plus cos of 120 plus A should be equal to 0. Of course, this particular problem, you need not use a transformation formula. Using the compound angle formula, cos A minus B and cos of A plus B also, it can be solved. In the exam, they don't ask you to use a particular formula. But if you use this transformation formula, it would be easier. Now, you know that when there are two terms, no, you can use any one of them. In this problem, there are three terms here. Any two you can start with. There is no restriction here. You can take these two or the first and the third. But look at the terms here and look at the right hand side. The right hand side is 0, isn't it? And that shows that all the terms on the left hand side, they should get cancelled. That is one hint we are getting. And here, if you take these two, see 120 minus A, 120 plus A, that is cos C plus cos D. Look at this formula, cos C plus cos D, so C plus D by 2. C plus D means when you add these two, minus A plus A gets cancelled. When you subtract C minus D, then A gets added up, 120 gets cancelled. So that's an advantage. But this, nobody says you have to do like this. Looking at the terms that have been given in the problem, you have to decide which two have to be taken. If there are only two terms, so no problem. When there are more than two terms, so you have to look at the terms that have been given and you have to see which is advantageous, which is beneficial. You have to take those pair of terms here. So let me start with the left hand side. Now keep the first term as it is, and cos A plus cos D, the seventh formula, it is 2 times cos of C plus D by 2, 120 minus A plus 120 plus A divided by 2 into, the other one is also cos term only, cos of 120 minus A minus, so both of them would be negative, minus 120 minus A divided by 2. Now this would be equal to cos A plus 2 times cos of, you just see minus A plus A, they get cancelled. 120 plus 120, that is 240 divided by 2. And in the second term, 120 itself gets cancelled. It is minus 2A by 2. So we have used the formula cos A plus cos D. Now further simplification is possible. Plus 2 into, you can cancel it as 120 times, that is cos of 120 degrees into 2 can be cancelled and it is cos of minus A. So what we have done here, it is cos of A, first term I have kept as it is, and here using the formula C plus D by 2, the value becomes 120 degree. C minus D by 2, 120 gets cancelled. It would be purely in terms of A. Now, the answer should be 0, which is on the right hand side. 0 means somehow all the terms, no, they should get cancelled here. Now, this would be equal to, write the first term as it is. Now, 2 into 120 degree. Where does it come? It comes in the second quadrant, not a standard value directly. So you could write it as 180 minus 60. Of course, you can use 90 plus 30 also. But you remember, when you use 90, you have to change the function to cofunction. When you use 180, the same function remains here. So 180 minus 60, because 120 could be written as 180 minus 60. And just now I told, in the earlier problem, so wherever I have come across this one, I have told you cos of minus theta is cos theta. So I can write it as cos A. So this results, you have to remember, the results of the allied angle. Now this is cos A plus Now again another allied iron rule. 120 degree, which quadrant does it come? It comes in the second quadrant where cos is negative and sin is positive. Now we are having cos ratio. So 180 minus theta is minus cos theta. That is minus cos 60 into cos A. Now cos A plus of minus minus 2 into what is cos 60? It is a standard value into that is 1 by 2 into cos A. Cancel this one. Finally what we are having? Cos A minus cos A. Therefore it is 0, which is the right hand side. So this is how we have to solve them. That is either any two ratios you could have taken. There were three on the left hand side. Any two you could have taken. By taking a proper pair of terms here, the solution of the problem becomes easier. So you have to think, you have to look at the terms. We cannot say you have to take this and that. It depends always upon the terms that have been given in the problem. Now let's move on to next problem. Here again we are proving certain results here. Sine of 2a plus sine of 5a minus sine a divided by cos of 2a plus cos of 5a plus cos of a. This should be equal to tan of 2a. See the left hand side, we have got enough number of terms. Whereas the right hand side, only tan of 2a we are having. And again, repeatedly I am telling, tan theta is equal to sin theta by cos theta. So that tells us that we have to somehow get sin 2a from the numerator, cos of 2a from the denominator, the answer would be tan of 2a. So any other term we'll be getting either in the numerator or denominator, they should get cancelled. Now again, there are three terms on the left hand side, in the numerator as well as in the denominator. All the formulae, we are having only two terms there, isn't it? So which two we have to select here? For that, now again, look at and decide. Suppose I take these two together, let me say. Sin 2a plus sin 5a, it resembles the first one, that is fifth formula. Sin c plus sin d, isn't it? Then we have c plus d by 2, 2 plus 5, 7a by 2, we get an odd number there. But we are having a whole number here, 2a, isn't it? So let me take this and this. See, c plus d by 2, 5a plus 1a by 2, 3a. And 5a minus 1a, c minus d by 2, 5a minus 1a, that would be 4a by 2, 2a. So we have to have 2a, and already 2a is there. So you will be getting 2a here also. So that is how we have to think. And so these two can be combined. The same argument holds good for the denominator terms also. So let me start with the left hand side and write the first term as it is. Sin 2a. Anyway, we have to have that. Plus 2 times sin c minus sin d formula. The sixth one. It is 2 cos c plus d by 2. 5a plus a by 2 into sin of 5a minus a by 2. A by 2. Similarly, write cos of 2a as it is. Plus 2 times cos c plus cos d, the seventh formula. It is purely a cosine product. 5a plus a by 2 into cos of 5a minus a by 2. Now, let me simplify here. It is sin of 2a plus, look here, 5a plus 1a, 6a, divided by 2, it becomes 3a. Similarly, sin of, it is 5a minus 1a, 4a divided by 2, that would be 2a. The denominator also, the same type of calculation, because same numbers we are having, so it becomes 2 cos 3a into cos of 2a. Observe, the same angles, same numbers are present, only the ratios are different. Now, look at the numerator as well as the denominator. Is there any common factor from the numerator as well as from the denominator? In the numerator, first term is sine of 2a and the second term 2 cos 3a into sine 2a. So take the common factor sine of 2a into right a bracket, better square bracket. When you take this sine of 2a, in the first term, what remains? That was a single term we are having, so 1 remains here. Now sine of 2a has been taken outside, 2 remains cos of 3a. So it becomes 2 cos 3a. Now, same thing in the denominator, cos 2a and cos 2a. Take that cos of 2a as common factor. What remains here? 1 remains again, plus 2 remains there, and another cos of 3a. Another cos of 3a. Now, clearly you can see that you can do the cancellation of the terms here. That is 1 plus 2 cos 3a and 1 plus 2 cos 3a and sin 2a by cos of 2a. If you want to connect one more step here, sin 2a by cos of 2a, because we know that sin theta by cos theta is tan theta. Hence, this becomes the right hand side. Now here, for applying the transformation formula for the numerator, denominator, 1 mark would be given. And afterwards, now taking out the common factor and writing the answer again, this is within 3-4 steps now we got the answer. So even it can be expected for just a 2 mark question here. Now, in the next problem, this is not directly connected with the transformation formula, but in the first session on transformation formula, I had given you about the trigonometric identities in a triangle. So that part I am using here because it's I am not making use of the transformation formula. Here some data is given to us. Using the data, we have to prove certain result here. So usually in such problems, we don't start with the LHS and arrive at the right hand side. Sometimes it can be done like that. Usually we start with the data and use the information about some formula which we know already and try to get both the LHS and RHS simultaneously. The data is like this. If A plus B plus C is equal to pi. Or the same problem can also be given in a triangle ABC, because you know that in any triangle, sum of the three angles is always equal to 180 degrees, or if you write in radian measure, it is pi. So the problem can be asked in two different ways. One is, in a triangle ABC, prove that. Or if A plus B plus C equal to 180 degree or pi, you prove the certain result. So in a triangle, if they mention, you should know this fact that the sum of the three angles is always equal to 180 degree. Now if this is the data, prove that tan A plus tan B plus tan C. What is this one? It is the sum of the tan ratios of the three angles. It should be equal to tan A into tan B into tan C. That means that if A plus B plus C is 180 degrees or pi radian, then the sum of the three tan functions will be equal to the product of the three functions. This is what you have to prove. So usually you can start with the left hand side or take both the sides and rearrange and get the result, but that is a roundabout procedure. So what I do is, in such problem, I start with the data. So how do you write this one? Given. Data are given. A plus B plus C equal to pi. Now shift any one of the angles to the right hand side. That is left to your choice. No restriction. Either take A or B or C, any one to the right hand side. Usually what we do is, we shift the last angle to the right hand side. Now take the tan ratio. Tan of A plus B would be equal to tan of pi minus C. You may remember when I did the trigonometric identities in a triangle in the first session of transformation formula, directly I had written tan of A plus B would be equal to minus tan C. So you can use that as a formula also. Again, I am showing that one. Pi minus C means it is in the second quadrant where tan is negative. Because I have used pi here, the same trigonometry function continues. That is, now on the left hand side, which formula does it resemble? It is tan of A plus B, the compound angle formula. Tan A plus tan B divided by 1 minus tan A into tan B. Now, tan of pi minus theta is minus tan theta. So, in the place of theta, I am having C. Now, it is only the cross multiplication. So, we have started with the data. Now, you cross multiply to get the both the left hand side, right hand side simultaneously. When you cross multiply, this would be equal to tan A plus tan B. Of course, in the denominator, we are having 1. So, need not be written that one. Tan A plus tan B into 1. Now, the other one, it is minus tan C, which was on the right hand side. You have to multiply by the denominator of the left hand side. It is tan B. Now, one more step and rearrangement of the terms, we get the answer. Now, tan A, right as it is, tan B, then equal to minus tan C into 1 is minus tan C. Minus of minus plus multiply that one, tan C into tan A into tan B. Now, this minus tan C, take it to the left hand side, automatically it changes the sign, it becomes plus tan A plus tan B plus tan C, and rearrange this one. Usually we write in the same order, tan A into tan B into tan C. Now, this was the answer we wanted. Sum of the three trigonometric ratios equal to product of the three trigonometric ratios. So, this is how we have to get. So, directly we got the left hand side equal to right hand side because we started with the data. And one more problem of the same type. So, I just want to take up with this itself. But the data is little bit different. That is, if A plus B plus C is equal to pi by 2. So here they don't give in a triangle ABC because here sum of the three angles has been given as pi by 2. Pi by 2 means it's 90 degrees. Then you have to prove certain result. Prove that tan A into tan B plus tan B into tan C plus tan C into tan A is equal to 1. That is, you observe the product here. Each term is a product of two tan ratios. We have taken them in cyclic order. Tan A into tan B plus tan B into tan C plus tan C into tan A. Now, when it is given like this, that is, it can also be written in using the sigma notation. You have to be familiar with this one. It is, you can write sigma tan A tan B equal to 1. Sigma always stands for summation. In that case, instead of writing the entire expression, sometimes they write it in the short form where they use the sigma notation. Sigma means it is first any one term would be given, usually the first term. You have to write the remaining two terms because there are three angles, there will be three terms here. So, remaining two terms, how do you write that one? Change them in the cyclic order. What do you mean by cyclic? A goes to B, B goes to C, C goes back to A. So, tan A, tan B will become tan B, tan C. Tan B, tan C will become tan C, tan A. So, instead of giving the entire big expression, it can also be given like this. You should be familiar with this notation also. Now, in this problem also, a data has been given to us. Start with the data, then try to get the result, both LHS, RHS, directly. Now, here, given, A plus B plus C equal to pi by 2. Now, here also, shift any one of them to the right-hand side. You can try afterwards, taking the other angle to the right-hand side. In the earlier problem also, I have taken C to the right-hand side. You can take A and B, C that you get the same answer. Now, because tan ratio is involved, you take again tan only. Tan A plus B would be equal to tan of pi by 2 minus C. Left hand side, as usual, the compound angle formula. Tan A plus tan B divided by 1 minus tan A into tan B. Now, here be careful. I am using the allowed angle rule. Pi by 2 means it is 90. 90 minus something means the angle comes in the first quadrant where all the trigonometric ratios are positive. So, no change of sign. In the earlier problem, it was minus. Now, whenever we use 90 or 270 as you know, function would be changed over to cofunction. What's the cofunction for tan? It is cot. So, I can write it as cot C. Now, again, cot and tan, they are cofunctions as well as reciprocal ratios. So, let me write it as 1 by tan C. Or you can write in the next step. Now, I am having tan A plus tan B divided by 1 minus tan A into tan B is equal to 1 by tan C. Now, here you cross multiply. Okay? You cross multiply. We are having tan A plus tan B into tan C. That is the right hand side. And here 1 into this one. That is 1 into 1 minus tan A into tan B. So, cross multiply means the left hand side numerator with the right hand side denominator and the other way also. Now, let me remove the brackets. Tan A into tan C. Tan A into tan C plus tan B into tan C. Into tan C. Right hand side, 1 is there. So, 1 into anything is same. 1 minus tan A into tan B. See, we have got the answer almost ready. Now, only this product, minus tan A tan B, take it to the left hand side. Therefore, we are having tan A into tan B. And let me write in the proper order, this term I am taking. Tan B into tan C. I am writing this one. Again, in the same order I am writing. Tan C into tan A. Now, what is left here? Only 1 on the right hand side. Therefore, to get the answer directly, you need not start with the left hand side in this type of problem. So, start with the data and using any one of the rules that you have learned so far, which is applicable to that particular problem, you can get the both the left hand side, right hand side equal to each other simultaneously. Now, in the coming session, I am going to work out some more problems on transformation formula. They may be little bit lengthy problem. So, before coming for the next session, before attending next session, you have to go through all the formulae. If you remember, if you by heart all of them, whatever I do here, you can follow easily. Otherwise, each time you cannot refer to the formula. You should have that in your mind. You have to by heart them. Then you can follow whatever I teach, whatever problems I work easily. Thank you.